If we want to look at how we can increase the quality of child protection, prevention and response in humanitarian action, I think what we need to look at is how we can roll out as much as we can the child protection minimum standards, and also to support the practitioners, giving them access to learning opportunity, such as the one you are participating to these days.
Implementation of the child protection minimum standards, together with refugee-specific tools such as the BIP guidelines, are key to strengthening the quality of our response and ensuring forcibly displaced and stateless children are protected.
The CPMS contribute to the professionalism of our sector, but also to the quality of programming and response to child protection issues in humanitarian settings, looking at both refugees and non-refugee settings.
Using the child protection minimum standards can help humanitarian actors to design protective and inclusive child protection responses for forcibly displaced and stateless children.
It provides clear and practical guidance for us child protection practitioners so we can adhere to globally accepted principles, but at the same time have the space to adopt, contextualize, and align with relevant national laws and policies.
Moreover, they provide guidance that can be easily applied to a wide range of humanitarian settings.
As an example, at global level, we've used the CPMS when developing the technical note last year at the onset of the global pandemic.
Crises like COVID-19 have shown us how important it is to include marginalized children, such as refugee and stateless children, into child protection responses, taking into account their specific needs. Rollout of the child protection minimum standards can really help us to identify these needs and strategies to address them.
It is critically important that we work together to improve the quality and effectiveness of our humanitarian programming to fully prevent and respond to any child protection concerns during emergencies.
The CPMS also supports us to link humanitarian and development action in East Asia and the Pacific, emphasizing the criticality of child protection system strengthening. This approach is important to rebuilding often weakened systems and addressing the range of vulnerabilities children face in evolving humanitarian situations. It provides us an opportunity to strengthen systems beyond the emergency, including through adaptations developed during crisis, and reminds us that emergency preparedness must be part of our child protection system strengthening efforts.
Given its importance, it is critical that we continue to distribute and promote the child protection minimum standards among governments, among international and national NGOs. This launch is one such useful initiative, and I would like to take the opportunity to thank the organizers for putting this together.